What's going on, everybody? I'm back with another update video of my Achilles rupture, and this is episode or video number 5. So in video number 4, I was just basically telling you guys like how I was getting around and how I was coping, you know, after the surgery, how everything was feeling. You know, I didn't know what my leg looked like after the surgery because they had it wrapped up in a big cast, you know, so I didn't know what anything looked like. So in that video, I just explained, you know, how that week went after surgery, you know, the pain I was having, the medicines they had me on, and how, you know, life was for me for that week. So if you missed that video, click the card up above and check that video out. But this is going to be my week 5 update. So this week, I went back, it's been 2 weeks since my surgery. They had me come back in to assess everything, to make sure everything was going okay, you know, make sure I was, you know, healing okay. And I really didn't know what they were going to do, but I just knew they was going to, you know, assess everything, make sure everything was going, you know, according to schedule. So, you know, I had my appointment today, saw the surgeon, you know, who did the operation, my doctor, you know, so he was kind of busy today, so he had some help with him. Had another doctor from the urgent care, because they had got an urgent care connected to it. So they had him come in and take my, so I found out they were going to be taking my stitches out. So I didn't know if I had staples or just regular stitches. I didn't know what was under that cast. So my doctor had one of his other help doctors come in to take my stitches out, take my cast off. And, you know, and then my doctor came in and saw everything once my cast was off and told me what he had to do during the surgery. And I got a better understanding of how he did everything. I got to see my scar and everything like that. And so the other doctor comes in, he takes my cast off. You know, it's like this, it was wrapped up in ACE bandage, but it was like a harder cast up under that, which he had to actually cut off, you know, with scissors. And then spread it apart to get my leg out. So when he was cutting it, you know, it was so thick, you know, them scissors he had, you know, once or twice, it dug into my foot. I'm like, oh, it hit my foot, you know, the scissors, because he's trying to cut this thick cast off. So once he got it off, I saw my wife. Well, I couldn't see it because it was on the back of my leg and I was laying down on my stomach. So I had my wife take a picture. Here's the picture right here. So I had her take a picture of it, and then she showed it to me. I'm like, oh my God, like, wow. So if you see the pictures, I had an incision at the top, about 3-4 inches. And then I had another one down the bottom, about 6 inches. So I'm like, wow. So he told me, my doctor told me he had to basically stretch the one end down to the other end, you know, and, you know, sew it back together and then, you know, stitch me up. So I didn't have any staples. I just had regular stitches. His helper doctor removed the stitches today. And he basically told me, my doctor told me, once he saw everything and how it was healing and stuff, he told me I had a couple options. He said my first option, because I'm self-pay, so I didn't have no insurance or nothing like that. He said, your first option, I can put you in a regular hard cast, like the one where you break your arm and all that, a hard cast, you know, with your foot pointed downwards for 4 weeks, and that'll be no cost to you. So I'm like, I don't really want to be in no cast, because just the cast I had after surgery sucked, you know, when you start itching and stuff, and I couldn't take no showers with it. So he was like, or you can go to our casting area and get the boot, and the boot here is going to run you about $600, and I know you don't want to spend $600 for our boot, you know. And I'm like, you know, I don't want to pay that right now either. It's like, oh, I can write you a prescription, so you can take this prescription to this other place down the street that sells the boots and stuff like that, and you can get it over there for about $70. I was like, okay, I'll do that option right there. So he wrote it up for me. And, you know, I was on my way, you know, and then they sent me down the hall to get another temporary splint. Got this one right here. So this one is basically like the same one I had before my surgery. So they gave me another one of these until I got my boot, because they wanted to see me back in a month. He said, in a month time, when I come back in January 17th, He said, then we're going to try to start, go to the next level. We're going to try to start putting weight on it, you know, and start, you know, doing the protocol, putting weight on it and doing exercises and stuff like that. I told the lady in the casting area while she was putting this splint on, I was telling her about everything, and she had a lot of knowledge too, because that's all she does is like put cast on people, and she's seen, you know, so many of these Achilles injuries, and she's wrapped up so many people and casted so many people and put the boot that they have on so many people. She was like, this is what you need to do. She was like, that prescription he gave you to the place down the street, if they're too expensive for you, go on Amazon or online in general and find the boot, because it's the same boot we have here for $600. You know, just get the one that's adjustable, one that's full motion where we can adjust, you know, your angle of your foot. You need that one. She was like, and they should run you no more than $60-$70. And I'm like, okay, cool. And she's like, if you need help, you know, setting it up, you can bring it back here and I'll help you, you know, adjust it. But if you don't need any help, you're fine. So I'm like, okay, great. And she was like, with the boot and with the splint you have now, you can take it off, you can start taking a shower, just be very careful, you don't want to re-injure yourself. You know, she's like, just be very careful, and, you know, basically telling me how to take care of my wound back there and everything. So me and my wife, we went down the street to see if this place had that boot. And what do you know? They didn't have the boot. They only had the 90-degree boot. It had no adjustments or nothing like that. So that lady at that place gave me two other places to check out. And they wanted me to make an appointment and had to have a prescription for the boot, which I had it. And they were like, they weren't taking no more appointments until January. I'm like, well, I need the boot now because my next appointment is January. So I need the boot now. So I ended up finding one on Amazon, and I'm going to put the link in the description for anybody that's going through this and want to save a lot of money on a boot. Even if you go through your insurance, you still might have to come out of pocket a lot. So if you want to save all that hassle, I'm going to put the boot I just ordered, you know, down in the description. I dropped the link. I got it from Amazon. It's supposed to be here in a couple days. And it's the one they want my foot down at 30 degrees to start. So then after a while, you know, then they'll raise it up until I'm back, you know, at a, you know, regular angle. So I'm waiting on that to come in. I'm rocking this splint now. I'm able to take this on and off and wipe my leg down and, you know, clean it finally. You know, my leg can finally breathe through this ace bandage right here, because that cast I had on, man, it was so hot and stuffy. You know, it's making my whole body hot, man. It's like it was itchy. I couldn't scratch anything. So now I'm back into the one I had before Thanksgiving, and we rocking and rolling now. So only thing I gotta wait, get my boot, and I'm gonna adjust it myself because it's pretty simple. It should be simple. And then I got my appointment on January 17th. We start putting weight on this thing and start going through the physical therapy and doing the exercises and stuff. And I'm going to be on my way because I'm getting back to 100%, man, because this sucks. Like, this really, really, really sucks. Like, I'm trying to be positive through this, but it's a lot of stuff I can't do. And people's asking me questions, can you do this? Can you do that? I'm like, no, I can't do that. No, I can't do that. Can you do this? Well, what if you get a chair and do this? I'm like, no, I can't do it. Like, I barely can help my wife take the dogs outside. They go to the bathroom. Like, it's a lot. And you got to be careful because you'll find out ways on how to get around and do things, but then you're not careful anymore. And then if you make a wrong step, or I'd have had that happen with this knee scooter I got, I'll be so fat. I'm so used to this knee scooter, I try to do things too quick, and I'll go to put my knee down on the scooter and I'll miss the seat. And then I have to catch myself. That happened to me before my surgery. I had to catch myself, and I stood flat foot on my hurt foot. And I was in excruciating pain in the grocery store when I did it. So, and then I even tried, before I even went to the doctors today, I went to the outlet malls to visit some family. And I thought I was good enough to, like, use my knee scooter and go around. And I was fine. But when I got home, boy, I was in some pain that night. You know, so I just had to tell myself, take it easy, let it heal, eat better. And just keep it elevated, take it easy, don't try to do too much. And the lady even told me when she was putting the splint on, she was like, now you're going to feel like you're okay and all that stuff. So when you wake up in the middle of the night, you got to go to the bathroom or whatever, make sure you're fully awake before you start trying to move to the bathroom. Because if you re-injure yourself and it separates again, you got to start this process all over. That means back to surgery. No, back to MRI to see what damage I did. Back to scheduling surgery. Back to recovery 2 weeks after surgery. Back to a boot or a cast for 4 weeks. And then PT and all that stuff. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to take care of this because I'm not trying to re-injure myself. But I'm just so glad to be in something lighter. And I'm going to update you guys again next Wednesday, because I want to tell y'all how the boot works out for me. So that's going to be next week's video, is me showing you guys the boot that I got and trying to understand it and showing you guys how I get around on it. And I'm also going to review the boot to see if it's even good quality or whatnot. But until next time, guys, is what I be thinking. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel, give this video a thumbs up, and hit the bell notification to be notified when I drop the rest of these videos, because I'm doing one every Wednesday, you know, giving you guys an update of life after my Achilles rupture surgery. So we got the ball rolling now. We going into the home stretch, you know, physical therapy and getting everything back right. You know, I'm feeling a little bit better, so we're going to get back to 100%. But until next time, guys, is what I be thinking, and I'm out.